These flat pieces of stone can really make a garden pop, but you may be surprised to know how this design can help hot, dry places that lack irrigation.
We had a hard time getting plants to grow, so we did a little bit of research and found that crevice gardens kind of have these xeric plants that are very low water use. So we have succulents out here, we have plants that take the hot and dry conditions, the drought conditions, drought tolerant, and so plus it's just visually stunning. It's a great entrance into this garden.
The kind of plants you put in a crevice garden should be chosen thoughtfully.
The other thing that you want to look for when purchasing plants are the low growing ones. So some of these will get a little bit taller, and so they're strategically placed more towards the back, but a lot of these are ground covers, so want to kind of make sure to take that into consideration on your plant selection.
What are some of the things that they have to keep in mind to know whether or not a crevice garden would really work for their environment?
Well, make sure that you have enough space. Sunlight, most of these plants are going to be full sun. And then you want to make sure that you can dig down deep enough to get that stone in there.
The soil is a mixture.
It's a third mushroom compost, a third potting soil, and a third permatil. So it's some of those really good moisture-holding soil. This is kind of modern, so if you have a more traditional, more formal landscape, this may not be the right choice.